Hello students, welcome to session number 7 in module number 2, diesel engine power system, that is engine starting methods. So today in this video I am going to explain what is engine starting system, why this engine starting system is required, and what are the types of engine starting system. Okay, so in engine, especially in a diesel engine, which is compression ignition engine, which uses very high compression ratios from 20 to 22, and hence it is very difficult to hand crank the engine. Okay, so especially in cold condition, it is very difficult to start the engine. Hence, some mechanical cranking systems are used for starting the diesel engine. So in the first this you can able to see, it is a car where you can insert key and you can crank it, and second sketch you can use hand lever, and even in third sketch also you can use hand lever and you can crank the engine. By that you can start the engine. The starting system includes storage battery, self-starter and compressed air supply, etc. The automobile engines are generally started by cranking. But in power plants, large capacity engines are used and are started. You cannot start by just cranking. So you have to employ some starting methods. In that, the very first system is a compressed air system, second one is electric starting, and third one is starting by auxiliary engine. So we will see what are those and how we can employ and when we can employ these systems, and we can start the diesel engine. First we will take up a compressed air system. When we say compressed air system, we can able to get that a compressor is going to supply air, isn't it? So compressor is going to supply the air, and you can able to see the line diagram here. So here you can able to see compressor, which is called as which is receiving the air, and it will store compressed, and pressure gauge is employed in order to maintain the pressure. It is supplied to the starter motor through main air supply, where integrated relay valve is adopted in order to maintain the safety, which is called as a safety valve. Okay, and interconnecting pipework you can able to see here. So in compressed air system, air system is commonly used for starting large diesel engines employed for stationary power plant service. A compressed air at about 17 bar is supplied from an air tank or air bottle, which is admitted to a few of the engine cylinder, making them work like reciprocating air motors to run the engine shaft. Okay, so then diesel fuel is admitted to remaining cylinders and ignites the normal way, causing the engine to start. So the air bottle or tank is charged by a motor or gasoline engine driven compressor. The system includes the following, as I mentioned earlier: storage tank or vessel, then safety valve, and then interconnecting pipework. Okay, Next, second starting method is electric starting. Whenever we say electric starting, we can able to get a motor is going to will be there. So motor, okay. So in electric starting or use of electric motors or self starters for such type of starting methods, these are employed for a small diesel and gasoline engines. A storage battery of 12 to 36 volts is used to supply power to an electric motor, which is geared to the flywheel with arrangement for automatic disengagement after the engine has started. Once engine has started, you can disengage that motor. Okay, so the motor draws heavy current and is designed to be engaged continuously for about 30 seconds only, and after which it is required to cool off for a minute or so and then re-engaged. Okay, this is done till the engine starts up. When the engine is running a small DC generator, the engine serves to charge the battery. Okay, this is about second type of starting methods. And third one is starting by an auxiliary engine. So generally a petrol driven engine is used. In this system, an auxiliary engine is mounted close to the main engine and drives the latter through a clutch and gears. The clutch is first disengaged and the auxiliary engine is gets started by hand or by self starter motor. When it is warmed up and runs normally, the drive gear is engaged so that engaged through the clutch so that the main engine is cranked for starting. To avoid the danger of damage to drive gear, it is desirable to have an overrunning clutch or starter type drive. Okay, this is about third starting methods. Before going to start the engine, we have to take necessary steps. Although a starting procedure may differ from engine to engine, but some common steps are to be followed. Number one, it is necessary to check air pressure and any possible air leakage in the air system. In case of electric motor starting, the battery condition should be checked regularly. Okay. Then it is necessary to check fuel system, lubricating system and cooling water system. There should not be any leakage. There should not be any damage of working components. We have to pressure, everything we have to check. Then engine is cranked after ensuring no load on the engine, and then decompression device is used by running the engine at a slow speed. The working fuel pump is to be checked, and the inspection is to be made for fuel and oil pressures, lubricating oil system, etc. The engine increase the engine speed gradually till it synchronizes with the station bus bar. Suddenly you don't increase the engine speed. This is about steps which is to be followed before starting the engine. Even for stopping the engine also we have to follow some steps, like reduce the speed of the engine gradually, practically no power is delivered. Ensure that there is no power is delivered by the alternator. Disconnect the unit from the bus and allow the engine to idle for a few minutes, and then stop it in conforming with the instruction detailed by the manufacturer. Okay, so these are the some steps we have to follow for starting as well as for stopping. With this, I will conclude this session. Thank you.